everyone. It's Stem Motion Derby for Life. As you can see, I need a haircut. But I am going to do a kind of a update video on how the Ghostbusters car is coming along. I believe I have it about 90% done, like ready to go for this next season. As you can see, I've been busy. I put two down bars in the back, for whatever reason I'm allowed to do it, kind of to keep the trunk down and keep my line of view intact, I guess. I actually had to cut out the X that was in there. The fair that I ran it at said that they didn't like that I wasn't supposed to do it like that, so they said that I had to cut it out. So I did that, and then I did it how I guess I thought I had to. Pretty much just weld it right to the trunk and then right to the top here, just a plate, and yeah, pretty simple to do. As you can see, the weather is starting to turn a little crappy. It's supposed to snow today, but we'll see if that actually happens. You guys know that I did the bracing of the humps. I used a 1/4-inch angle iron. I also had to change. Get this thing up here. Had to change my gas tank protector because they said that this was that this was sitting up too high back here, but I looked in the rules and they changed it to 30 inches, and I had mine set at like 40 something, so I just cut it and shortened it. Now it's sitting at the right length. I might have to cut this at the fairgrounds. I don't know if they're gonna make me do it, but I might have to cut that, but I just left it just to see if I could get by with it. I also added some extra bracing, just to keep everything there, because if this whole, I don't want, like, this whole back decides to start to buckle in or whatever, this will help, because it would have to push the whole cage forward then. But I just did that on both sides. I added an extra bracing in here because I just butt welded it to the back bar and to the front bar. Past experience says that will break, but I don't know if my welds will probably hold, but I just to make sure, I added a brace in here just in case, because I mean this whole door has to come in like 4 inches. I was gonna get it tighter, but that's as far as I could get it to actually make it work in there. I will be repainting this. I don't know yet what it will be. I might stay with the Ghostbusters theme, but we will see. I'm gonna power wash it off and then just give it a fresh coat of paint. I might actually go with a different theme for it, but we will see. See what else. Floor's starting to rust out in a couple spots, but I'm not worried. I think it should be fine. The floor over there is starting to buckle, but whatever. I'm not worried. Coming along the sides, let's go on this side first since I'm over here. I actually added some extra plating. I was allowed 20 inches of frame repair, and I just added, and I could go 1/4-inch thick. plating, and I've plated up here just to kind of strengthen it up. I didn't really do anything else, just added a plate and called it good. But back here, I believe it is actually starting to buckle right up here. As you can see, it's starting to bend in here. So I decided to add extra plating in here. I removed the brake line holder thing, I don't know. And I actually had to break the brake line so I could move it. And then I just welded it back onto the plate just to have it there. And then if I decide to actually fix my front brakes, then it's all good to go. Actually, I cut the other side, and I should have not done that, but whatever. Oh well. I'll just have one front brake. The other side is actually worse. Actually, you'll see that I'm starting on a new project in there. I've been getting this one going, this blue car going today. I just decided to fix the frame because the frame was like shot. I'll have to make a video of how that frame was like that front frame was like up here, like it was insanely junk. But I think I ended up fixing it. I'll go in there and take a shot for you guys. Right here, I just added a little plate. It's nothing wide. It's nothing spectacular. I just added it on there just to see if it would strengthen it just a little bit. But we will see if that actually will work. But here's... try to get the camera in here. Here's where it buckled pretty bad. As you can see right there, that it's bubbling up. That used to be straight, I guess you could say, but it's starting to buckle right in here. So I just added a plate in there and then I filled it, and hopefully that will keep it nice and strengthened, I guess the word would be. I don't know if that's actually gonna work out any good or whatever, but we will see. I will be using the front end of this car a little bit more. I also have to fix the front horns a little bit. They're starting to tweak in. So what I'll do is I'll take a power jack and I'll just put it in between the two, and then I'll just push them out. And then I will weld my front bumper on, which it will be a 74 Impala bumper, and that's one of the really good bumpers. But that will be done later on, closer to the derby season or derby day. Maybe I'll even run this earlier in the year, but I have not decided yet. But yeah, there you go, guys. Flip the camera screen. There you go, guys. There's the Deadpool car. It's coming along pretty good. It just needs a motor, tranny, and maybe a little bit more welding. But otherwise, I think she's pretty much good to go. Probably gonna. Like I said, I'm gonna power wash this thing off, and then I'm gonna probably repaint it, give it a new look. But again, guys, thank you guys for watching all my videos. I really appreciate it. I'm gonna try to do a few more videos today to kind of get more content on. But otherwise, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. If you like this video, like the video, and keep telling more and more people about this channel. It's always a new learning experience for me personally. This is just stuff I'm randomly doing. I'm not by no means any necessary good at building cars. I'm just building it the way I think they should be built. I don't know I'll find out in the derby ring if it's gonna hold up. But thank you guys for watching all my videos. I really appreciate it. If you got pictures of cars that you want to send me, I'll make a one big video of all your guys' cars. I'll what the type of car is, who built it, and if it's ran, how they did, if they give you the information. But yeah, but thank you guys for everything. I think that's about it. So again, thank you. I love you guys, and we'll catch you guys later.